ですよ。 Can you all take your seats so we can get started? Please take your seats.
Thank you. Good morning. Thank you. I'm Jim Harris. I'm the president of the board of National History Day, and welcome to the 2016 Kenneth E. Behring National History Day Award Ceremony. I, and I know all of my fellow board members, look forward to this event because it is a crowning achievement for all of you and a crowning achievement for this organization after a year's work. You deserve a tremendous pat on the back and awards, and they will come very shortly, and they'll be presented by the executive director of this wonderful organization, a woman of tremendous power, Kathy Gorn.
Are you ready?
Yeah.
You wanna know who won?
Yeah.
You ready?
Yeah.
Okay, well, I'm not quite yet. First, before we celebrate, and this is a wonderful day of celebration in many different ways, which I'm going to tell you about in a little bit. But before that, although this week we celebrate history and education, we also mourn the senseless loss of life perpetrated by those who seek to take us backward. We, all of us here in this room, all those History Day participants, and teachers, and coordinators, and judges, and volunteers all around the country and around the globe. We know that education is the ultimate weapon to defeat the forces that divide us. And studying the past is now more important than ever, because studying the past teaches us about how and why we are all connected and helps us learn tolerance. Keep studying history. And now please join me in a moment of silence to honor the victims of the terrorist attack in Orlando. And now let's celebrate. Let's celebrate this wonderful week and the scholarship of all these students. And first, I want to celebrate an individual who's given so much to National History Day. And that's my friend, Jim Harris. Dr. Jim Harris has been president of the National History Day Board of Trustees for the last 4 years. He has guided our organization. He has guided me as a mentor and as a friend, and in fact, sometimes as my surrogate father. He has contributed much to the growth of National History Day as he's been on the board for many years. And he is stepping down as president after this program. And I would like you all to join me in saying a very, very special thank you to Dr. Jim Harris. Thank you. And now we've got another person to celebrate. In fact, a whole family to celebrate. As you know, this is the Kenneth E. Behring National History Day Contest. And just a couple of days ago, Mr. Kenneth E. Behring celebrated his 88th birthday. Now that's a man who's made a lot of history. And he celebrated maybe just a little too hard, so he's still sleeping. But his lovely wife, Pat Behring, and his son, David Behring, are here to accept a card, a birthday card, a birthday wish for Kenneth Behring on his 88th birthday. A card has been signed by just about every student participant here at National History Day this week. And also to present to you for your annual souvenir of National History Day, our coordinator from Pennsylvania and two Pennsylvania students would like to present you with your annual packet of buttons. And also, we'd like to present from the students a set of buttons for Dr. Harris. Okay. Everybody? Before we celebrate student achievement, got one more special celebration here today. For the last year, the National Endowment for the Humanities has been celebrating its 50th anniversary. And we have been celebrating our 40th anniversary with the National Endowment for the Humanities. In 1974, National History Day began with 127 students in Cleveland, Ohio. Within 2 years, David Van Tassel, the founder of National History Day, contacted the National Endowment for the Humanities and asked if they might be interested in taking a look at what students in Ohio were doing. NEH responded with a grant to take History Day into Indiana and Kentucky. It then spread to Iowa. And from there it fanned out all across the country and now across the globe. Never would have been possible without the support of NEH. They came through with a planning grant in 1976. They came through with another grant in 1978 to take it nationally. And National History Day celebrated its first national competition in 1980. The endowment continued to support National History Day through 1984. And then thereafter, we have worked together on teacher summer institutes, on special prizes, on webinars, presentations of all kinds. We have become true partners together, enhancing history education worldwide. I am so pleased to be able to present to the National Endowment for the Humanities, represented here by Deputy Chairman Margaret Plimpton. Julia Wynn, and Eva Caldera. For putting the National in History Day. Margaret Clinton. Thanks, Kathy, and thanks to all of you. What a glorious beginning to a terrific day. On behalf of William Adams, Chairman of the National Endowment for the Humanities, I bring congratulations to the students, teachers, and family members who are here today. Students, you have excelled at every level of National History Day competition. And now, here you are at the national contest. You are all NEH scholars, and we are thrilled to be able to celebrate your achievements and honor your year of hard work. Yay! At the NEH, we are proud of our long relationship with National History Day, which, as you've just heard, dates back to the 1970s, when the institution we now know as National History Day was just getting started. We provided funding that helped turn a small regional program into one that is truly national and indeed international. We're excited to see how it has grown from those modest beginnings in Ohio. Hundreds of thousands of students across the United States and its territories and in several countries in Asia and Central America take part in History Day competitions each year. We are honored to have played a part in that growth. Over the years, NEH has supported National History Day in many ways. We have funded National History Day professional development for teachers, and we continue to offer programs for teachers and students showcasing the ways that NEH-funded resources, for example, the Chronicling America, which features over 10 million pages of digitized historic American newspapers, can be used in History Day projects. This year, as we have for several years, we are pleased to sponsor the first prizes in 16 categories, as well as the special Chronicling America prize. Even more than the prizes, however, we take great pride in the mission we share with National History Day. NHD encourages students to be critical thinkers. Supported by educators and librarians, students go beyond the easy answers presented in textbooks to scour primary sources documents, explore a multitude of factors and perspectives, and present a complex rendering of the past. Through primary sources, History Day students consider the flesh and blood people involved in historic events. These human stories bind us to the past and help us envision our roles in present events and to imagine our shared and collective future. Like National History Day, we at NEH value the crucial skills students develop while working on their projects, conducting research, understanding and analyzing historical evidence, building a case, and sharing knowledge. These skills are important for scholars, but they are also essential for thoughtful, engaged citizens. As NEH celebrates the 50th anniversary of its founding, we celebrate the transformative humanities programs we have supported. National History Day, which received the National Humanities Medal in 2011, is prominent among these. And as we celebrate the history of our fruitful collaboration with National History Day, We also look forward to continuing the partnership and to more excellent work in the future. Thank you, and again, congratulations to you all. Well, you all know that although I enjoy getting the recognition as being the leader of National History Day, it's only because I have the best staff in the world working beside me. Yeah. They work hard all year round, but especially step up their game during contest season. And if you enjoyed your week, it's because of the following incredible individuals. Deputy Director Kim Fortney. Director of Programs, Lynn O'Hara. Director of Communications, Gary Pettit. Finance Manager, Lorena Torres. Office and Events Manager, Erica Washington. Contest Manager, Adrian Harkness. Program Assistant, Amanda Hendry. IT Manager, Elaine Kuntz. And our Admin Assistants, Renee Bow and Janebo. Oh, their mom says they're working. We also this year want to thank our teaching fellow, Amy Boning. And our most incredible contest interns and NHD alums, Whitney Oakes and Zoe Honeck. And you know, it takes a lot more people than those that I've just listed to make National History Day what it is and make this contest run this week as smoothly as it does. And that's because we have incredible volunteers from the judges and the coordinators, teachers, parents, brothers, sisters, everybody joins in the fun. But I'd like to recognize a few who've given their entire week to National History Day. Our stalwart volunteers, Linda Abood, Casey Smith. Where are you, Casey? You're sitting there with Laura. There she is. Ann Edwards. Becky Butts. And this year we got a twofer. Her husband, Jim Butts. Adolfo Torres. And joining us, coming all the way from Guatemala just to help out with National History Day, Alejandrina Castro. I also want to say a big thank you to Skien Communications for their generous donation of the webcast. Those of you out there in webcast land, we are very fortunate to have their donation this year because, as you know, the History Channel used to provide the webcast for us and could no longer do that. But the good people at Skien Communications came through for us, so another big round of applause. Okay, certificates and evaluations. Many coordinators have picked up their students' packets and will be distributing them to you personally. So, I'm going to read the names of those states and affiliates whose coordinators have picked up the packets and will be giving them to you themselves. So, if you hear your state or affiliate name called, that means do not go up to Heritage Hall after the ceremony to pick up your packet. Okay, I was wrong. It's been a long week. So many coordinators have decided to pick up your packets that the list of those who are not picking up their packets is shorter, so I don't have to read as many. So, if you hear your state or affiliate name, go up to Heritage Hall. At the end of the ceremony, the doors will remain locked until the ceremony is completely over. So, District of Columbia, Maryland, Missouri, Nebraska, New Hampshire, New Jersey, New York, Oregon, Pennsylvania, Rhode Island, South Carolina, Virginia, Wyoming, and NHD South Asia. Go to the Heritage Hall in about 3 hours. We'll try to make it a little quicker than that. Okay, as I call the names of the winners, I would like you to make your way quickly to the stage. Come up the stairs over here to your left, my right. Then you'll walk across the stage and go down the stairs over here. Pause for a picture. Teachers of winning students, please accompany your students to the stage. Okay, everybody got that? All right. Let's get this show on the road. So, we'll start with junior paper. And I'd like to ask David Behring to help me present the awards for junior paper winners. In third place, taking home a bronze medal from Plantation, Florida, Flora Rannis. Flora attends American Heritage School. Flora's teacher is Leslie Porges. And the title of her paper, From Hopeless to Heroic, The Polar Voyage of the USS Jeannette. Taking home a silver medal, second place, from Kailua, Hawaii, Owen Barr. Owen attends Kailua Intermediate School. His teacher is Leslie Ringett, and the title of his paper, The European Organization for Nuclear Research, Exploration and Counter and Exchange Through Nuclear Physics. And to help me present the gold medal, the NEH Scholars Award is Chairwoman Clinton. Every first place. You'll be going up and down, up and down. Okay. All right. In first place, from Baytown, Texas, Benjamin Warford Johnston. Benjamin attends Gentry Junior High. His teacher is Tara Fountain. And the title of his paper, American Colonial Committees of Correspondence, Encountering Oppression exploring unity and exchanging visions for the future. Taking home a bronze medal for senior paper from Baytown, Texas, Tomas De La Rosa. Tomas attends Ross S. Sterling School. His teacher is Donna Britt, and the title of his paper, An Alien Race That Should Be Segregated Socially, Mendez versus Westminster. In second place, from St. Paul, Minnesota, Cameron Frankie. Cameron attends Washington Technology Magnet School. Teachers are Steve Cox, David Connors, and Eric Anderson. And the title of Cameron's paper, The Black Death, An Unforeseen Exchange, Europe's Encounter with Pandemic Sparked an Age of Exploration. While we're waiting, I'll read the first place NEH Scholar Award, which goes to a student from Lexington, Kentucky, Amir Abujuad. Amir attends Henry Clay High School. Teacher is Chris Snow. And the title of his NEH Scholar paper, A Pure Invention, Japan, Impressionism, and the West, 1853 to 1906. And now for a few special prizes. I would like to ask Leon Potter and Jane McAuliffe of the Library of Congress to help me present the award for an outstanding entry on discovery or exploration in history. All of you did exploration in history, right? You have an award for each one, right? to represent all the students for an outstanding entry on discovery, exploration, and history in the junior division from Jackson, Wyoming, River Gayton. River attends Jackson Hole Middle School. Teacher is Gregory Poduska, and the title of the winning junior individual exhibit, Anne Mansfield Sullivan and Her Remarkable Journey to Dramatically Change Our World's Perception of Disabled Individuals. And in the senior division, for their senior group website from Shanghai, China, Patrick Ruan, Emily Jang, Kiong, or Anna Wei. They attend Concordia International School, Shanghai. Their teachers are Michael Kennedy, Cindy Farley, and Randy Farley. And the title of their website, The Mogo Rock Grottos, A Thousand Years of Buddhism. And for an outstanding entry on American labor history, which is sponsored by the American Labor Studies Center, I'd like to ask National History Day trustee Ted Prossy to help present the award. For an outstanding entry on the history of American labor, from Barton, Vermont, Hannah Pogini and Annika Sosia. They attend St. Paul's Catholic School. Their teacher is Susan Wilmette, and the title of their junior group performance, The Newsboy Strike of 1899. And now, for an outstanding entry on equality in history, sponsored by Celie and Tabitha Niehaus, I'd like to ask both Celie and Tabitha to join me in presenting the awards. In the junior division, for an outstanding entry on equality in history, from Harrisburg, Pennsylvania, Megan Wauer. Megan attends St. Margaret Mary School. Her teachers are James Collins and Mary Jo Pronio. and the title of her junior individual performance, Women's Suffrage Movement, Carrie Chapman Kant Explores Women's Rights. And in the senior division, for an outstanding entry on equality in history, for their senior group website, from New Hyde Park, New York, Vanessa Sun, Rachel Kim, and Alan Chen. They attend Herricks High School. Their teachers are Melissa Jacobs and Samantha Garantabi, and the title of their website, The Freedmen's Bureau, Standing on the River of Jordan, Exchanging Chains for Freedom's Opportunity. Testing. The students are back in New York taking their tests. All of you students here, and all students around, all over History Day land, you know that you wouldn't be here, you couldn't do History Day in the first place, if not for your teachers. Your teachers have worked very hard, gone above and beyond what so many others do in the classroom, well above and beyond, taking on National History Day and guiding you through the process. Join me in congratulating all the teachers. Teachers of National History Day, please stand up. All of you, well, we can only ask for a few to come down to represent all of you. To help me give these awards, the Patricia Behring Teacher of the Year Awards is Mrs. Patricia Behring. Before we announce the awards, we would like all of the Patricia Behring state and affiliate winners to come down to the floor.
Remember the name, I don't know if I remember. Have them turn around. Sorry to... I know you guys want to take pictures.
This is so exciting for me. I'm looking at all those wonderful winners of states, and I'm a Californian, and I'm also from Florida and Wisconsin, but today I'm from every state in the union because I'm so proud of the teachers. And I just call them, they're all mine. But I wish they all could win tonight or today or tomorrow, whatever. They've won already by bringing you wonderful students here to Nationals. And I've been proud to meet as many as possible while I've been here. This is the height for me of announcing the awards at Nationals. And so I'm going to announce the junior division winner this year. I've already met this gentleman, Jonathan Millers from California. And now, I also have the wonderful privilege of announcing the Senior Teacher of the Year, Jenny Zenner Rao, Minnesota.
Teachers, because Mrs. Behring is going to come down for a picture with all of you. And while they're doing that, we will move on to Junior Individual Exhibit. And to help me present the medals for Junior Individual Exhibit, I'd like to ask National History Day Trustee and NHD alum, John Gillum, to help me. In third place, from Owings, Maryland, Parker Nichols. Parker attends Northern Middle School. His teacher is Carly Martis. And the title of his exhibit, Brainstorm, William James, Pioneer of the Mental Frontier. In second place, From Plantation, Florida, Rudy Moise. Rudy attends American Heritage School. His teacher is Leslie Porges and Daryl Trowbridge. And the title of his exhibit, How the U.S. Dollar Rebuilt the World. And in first place, the NEH Scholar Award goes to student from West Hartford, Connecticut, Mia Porcello. Mia attends Sedgwick Middle School. Her teacher is Jennifer Hunt. And the title of her gold medal winning junior individual exhibit, Florence Wald, Exploring Medical Boundaries, Exchanging Hospitals for Hospice. Where is she? They're way up there. And now for senior individual exhibit, I'd like to ask one of our stalwart volunteers to help me present the medals, Becky Butts. From Colorado, by the way. Colorado. In third place, taking home a bronze medal from Cambridge Springs, Pennsylvania, Michaela Peters. Michaela attends Cambridge Springs High School. Her teachers are John Workmeister and Sarah Thompson. And the title of her exhibit, Breaking Biological Boundaries, Rosalind Franklin and the Experimental Foundation of the Double Helix Theory. Taking home a silver medal for senior individual exhibit, from Odessa, Missouri, Hannah Scott. Hannah attends Odessa High School. Her teacher is Paula Hawk. And the title of her exhibit, A City Under Siege, Delivering Hope One Flight at a Time on the Air Bridge to Berlin. And to help me present the NEH Scholar Awards, I'm going to ask Eva Caldera from the National Endowment for the Humanities to help present the medals. In first place, the NEH Scholar Award goes to From Lamars, Iowa, Kelly Sussmill. Kelly attends Lamars Community High School. Her teacher is Jean Rust. And the title of her senior individual exhibit, The Transcontinental Railroad, Exploring the West, Encountering Pitfalls, and Exchanging Cultures. And now for a few special awards. For an outstanding entry on African American history, I'd like to ask Margaret Miles to join me in presenting the medal. This is sponsored by the Carter G. Woodson Home National Historic Site of the National Park Service. For an outstanding entry on African American history, for their senior group performance, from Plano, Texas, Alex Spiride, Mark Mething, Joshua Matthew, Kimberly Wynn, and Jude Franklin. They attend Plano East Senior High School. Their teachers are Kathy Witcher and Richard Walker, and the title of their senior group performance, I Too Am American. I'm going to start a "you must be present to win" policy. To help me present the award for an outstanding entry on the U.S. Constitution, sponsored by the National Archives and Records Administration, I'd like to ask Jim Gardner to help me present the medals. For the Junior Division, outstanding entry on the U.S. Constitution. For their junior group performance, from Middlebury, Connecticut, Juliana Rodriguez, Max Bueno, Samantha Gilbert, Emily Strickland, and Joe Sarah. They attend Memorial Middle School. Their teachers are Sharon Ladarsik and Carl Buckley. And the title of their junior group performance, Alexander Hamilton Explores a Financial System for the New Nation of America. And in the senior division, for an outstanding entry on the history of the U.S. Constitution, for his senior individual website, from Huntingtown, Maryland, Brian Holt. Brian attends Huntingtown High School. His teacher is Jonathan Moreland. And the title of his website, The Iran-Contra Affair, Patriotism or Politics?
After the ceremony.
And now for outstanding entries on the history of World War II, sponsored by the National World War II Museum, I'd like to ask Colin Mackemson to help me present the awards. In the junior division, for their junior group website, from McDonough, Georgia, Kennedy Anderson and Emily Garrison. They attend Impact Academy. Their teacher is Kelly Theodosian. And the title of their junior group website, Exploring the Secret City of Oak Ridge, Tennessee. And for the senior division, from Moriarty, New Mexico, Morgan McCall. Morgan attends Moriarty High School. Morgan's teacher is Amy Page. And the title of Morgan's senior individual performance, A Home Away from Home, Exploring Soldier Morale and Exchanges of Patriotism Through the USO. And now for an outstanding entry on the history of medicine, sponsored by the National Library of Medicine. I'd like to ask Mark DeJong to help me present the medals. Okay, he's not here. He is here in spirit. So I'd like to ask Dr. Harris to present the award. For an outstanding entry on the history of medicine, for their senior group website, from Freehold, New Jersey, Tassin Alam, Angela Zhao, Michael Abelar, Tiffany Paul, and Varun Sadavathula. They are homeschooled, teacher is Naima Alam, and the title of their senior group website, Henrietta Lacks, Ordinary Woman, Extraordinary Cells. And the students are not here. Where? They've got a good excuse. They're at graduation. Okay. To help me present the awards for junior individual performance, I'd like to ask another stalwart volunteer, Ann Edwards, to join me in presenting the medals. All right. So, in third place, junior individual performance, taking home a bronze medal from Forest Lake, Minnesota, Strom Norcross. Strom attends Lakes International Language Academy. Teacher is Kari Rodriguez. And the title of his junior individual performance Strength in Numbers, Exploring the Role of Industrial Unions Through the 1894 Encounter Between the American Railway Union and the Great Northern Railway. In second place, taking home a silver, from Thompson, Georgia, Jasmine Hewley. Jasmine is homeschooled, teachers Michelle Zupan, and the title of Jasmine's second place winning performance, Black, White, and Blue, Vivian Thomas and the Cure for Baby Blue Syndrome. And for first place, the NEH Scholar Award, I would like to ask Julia Wynn from the National Endowment for the Humanities to help. In first place, the NEH Scholar for Junior Individual Performance from Waco, Texas, Harper Hoover. Harper attends Atlas Academy. Teachers are Sandra Gibson and E.P. Garth. And the title. Title of the performance, Dare to Explore, How the Founding of the National Geographic Society Changed the Scientific Community Forever. And now, senior individual performance. Students, you might want to wait a little bit for your teachers. I would like to invite Tabitha Niehaus to help present the awards for senior individual performance. In third place, taking home a bronze medal from McDonough, Georgia, Susanna Dormini. Susanna attends Sola Phi Homeschool. Teacher is Ann Dormini. And the title of her performance, Levittown, Fair Housing for All. In second place for our senior individual performance, from Boulder, Colorado, Isabella Boland. Isabella attends Fairview High School. Her teachers are Lee Campbell Hale and Scott Peoples. And the title of her performance, On Track to Citizenship, The Exploration, Encounter, and Symbolic Exchange of the Wanamaker Expedition of Citizenship to the North American Indian. NEH Scholars, NEH Scholar Award for Senior Individual Performance. From Lawrence, Kansas, Elisa Trujillo. Elisa attends Bishop Seabury Academy. Her teacher is Sonia Zarnecki, and the title of her gold medal performance, Exploring and Exchanging Rhythms, Master Juba and the Early History of Tap Dance. And now for a few more special prizes. For the Legacy Award, I'd like to ask Dr. Harris to present the medals. The Legacy Award goes to Matthew Brassard from Baytown, Texas. Matthew attends Impact Early College High School. Teachers are Steve Koester and Michael Fanning, and the title of his senior group documentary, From Confederation to Nation. The next award is sponsored by the National Women's History Museum, and I'd like to ask Elizabeth Maurer to hand out the awards. For outstanding entry on women's history. From Cumberland Center, Maine, Madison Albert. Madison attends Greeley Middle School. Madison's teacher is Kathy Kearney. And the title of Madison's junior individual exhibit, Protector of the Children, Exploration, Encounter, and Exchange in the Florence Kelly's Fight Against Child Labor. And now for outstanding entries on Irish or Irish American history, sponsored by the Ancient Order of Hibernians and the Ladies Ancient Order of Hibernians. I'd like to ask Mary Hogan and Marilyn Madigan to join me in presenting the award and Mike McCormick. First, second place, $1,500 scholarship assistance by the Ladies Ancient Order of Hibernians. Goes to Mary Brow from South Hamilton, Massachusetts. Mary attends Hamilton Wyndham Regional High School. Her teacher is Vincent Fucci. And the title of her senior individual performance, Mary Mallon, Science Bends to the Anti-Irish Prejudice. And the first place award for outstanding entry in Irish or Irish American history, 2 round trip tickets to Ireland. And the award goes to Aubrey Mando and Elena Madison of Nebraska City, Nebraska. They attend Lord's Central Catholic High School. Teachers are Roxanne Penfield and Kathy Thomas. And the title of their junior group documentary, The British Government, Exploring Ways to End the Irish Famine. And next, it takes a lot of sponsors to make National History Day run. So in addition to the wonderful support by the Behring family and the National Endowment for the Humanities, we also have support from Southwest Airlines. This is the official airline of National History Day. And to congratulate the students, though he couldn't be here himself, the CEO of Southwest Airlines, Gary Kelly, has presented a video for you.
Good morning. Congratulations. You have made it after months of research, writing, advising, and presenting. You made it to the award ceremony for 2016 Kenneth E. Behring National History Day Contest. And your work is among the top 1% of entries from around the world. Southwest Airlines congratulates each and every one of you on this amazing accomplishment. Throughout your experience, you've had family, friends, and teachers support you. They helped you reach new heights and fly further than you thought you could go. From me and all of the employees at Southwest Airlines, congratulations.
And to show their appreciation for your hard work, Southwest Airlines is donating 2 round-trip tickets to be raffled off at the end of the program. And you must be present to win. I'm going to ask Allison Sturma and Yosef Sultan from the United States Institute of Peace to help me present the awards for an outstanding entry on global peace. In the junior division, from Honolulu, Hawaii, Summer Royal. Summer attends Stevenson Middle School. Summer's teacher is Rose Yonamin. And the title of Summer's junior individual documentary, The Shock of the Century, How the Sputnik Won the First Space Race, Rising from the Ashes of Peenemünde on the Wings of Soviet Propaganda. And for the senior division, outstanding entry on global peace. For their senior group performance from Staunton, Virginia, Maggie Olshov, Shalyn McFarling, and Rachel Knight. They attend Augusta COA. Their teacher is Lisa Olshov. And the title of their performance, Eleanor Roosevelt and the Promise of Human Rights. And now for Junior Individual Documentary. I'm going to ask another one of our stalwart volunteers, Diane Grogan, to help present the medals. In third place for Junior Individual Documentary, from Plantation, Florida, Joshua Hoffman. Joshua attends American Heritage School. Teacher is Leslie Porges. And the title of his documentary, Boundless Possibilities, America's Journey to the Moon. In second place for Junior Individual Documentary, from Johnston, Iowa, Akshaya Kumar. Akshaya attends Johnston Middle School. Teacher is Kathy Paul. And the title of the second place documentary, Nikola Tesla, Exploring an Electrical Era. And first place, the NEH scholar, Julia Wynn. You would help me do this. The NEH scholar award goes to Bobby Ayer from Redmond, Washington. Bobby attends Evergreen Middle School. Teacher is Nicole Kessler. And the title of the first place junior individual documentary, The Awakening of the Sleeping Giant, How Sino-American Rapprochement Triggered China's Meteoric Rise and What It Means Today. And now for Senior Individual Documentary. I would like to invite National History Day Contest Manager Adrian Harkness to help present the awards. In third place for Senior Individual Documentary from Springdale, Arkansas, Rebecca Love. Rebecca attends Springdale High School. Her teacher is Winfield Watson. And the title of her documentary, Marshall Islands, A Culture Damaged Through Scientific Exploration and Encounters with Western Civilization. In second place, from San Diego, California, Adam Nussbaum. Adam attends Francis Parker School. His teacher is Sherry Redlings. And the title of his documentary, Silence Kills, Temoignage and the Dilemma of Humanitarian Aid. And first place, NEH Scholar. Senior Individual Documentary, Gold Medal. From Unalaska, Wisconsin, Aditya Eliani. Aditya attends Unalaska High School. Teacher is Lisa Reimbler. And the title of the gold medal documentary, The Journey of Sugar, Neither Short Nor Sweet. Next, I'm going to read the Outstanding State and Affiliate Entry Awards. Don't shoot. Okay. Please hold your applause until the end. I'm going to read these very quickly. Students, come down, receive medal, and go off to the other side, just like everyone else, but we want you to keep it moving. So, here we go. The outstanding entries, starting with Wyoming for her senior paper, Fiacra Roddinghouse. For junior group website, Quinn Ellingson and Sophie Parker and Lucy Kimmel. From Wisconsin, Annalise Callaghan, senior individual performance. For junior individual exhibit, Mackenzie Corrant. From West Virginia, Alea Dye, senior paper. For junior individual performance, Peter Galvin. From Washington, senior individual exhibit, Marissa McMaster. For junior group website from Washington, Maxing Jang and Clarissa Cho. For Virginia, for senior individual performance, Maloney Wright. Charlie Adams, for junior individual exhibit. From Vermont, for senior individual documentary, Ayana Fortin for Junior Individual Website, Willa Yonkman. From Utah, Marin Burgess for Senior Individual Exhibit. For Junior Group Website, Daniel Nelson, Spencer Standing. From Texas, Senior Group Exhibit, Mateo Requenes, Ramiro Solis, Christian R. Perez, Jason Perez, and Mabel Garza. For Junior Group Exhibit, Matthew Lanning, Tyler Murphy. From Tennessee, Deanna Upchurch for Senior Individual Documentary. For Junior Group Performance, Hannah Robbins, Eli Harrison. From South Dakota, for Senior Group Exhibit, Sophie Curry, Belle Hine, and Samantha Cannelly. For Junior Group Documentary, Mitch Eichacker, Jonathan Smith. From South Carolina, Adriana Ballinger, for Senior Individual Exhibit, or Website. For South Carolina, for Junior Individual Performance, Hannah Mullen. From South Asia, for Senior Group Exhibit, Elvina Retania, Clarinza Jaja, Rosa Tia, and Susanna Leanto. For Junior Group Documentary, Lauren Lee, Jenny Poli, and Joy Jensubaki. From Rhode Island, Rebecca Carcieri, for Senior Individual Website. For Junior Group Documentary, from Rhode Island, Caden Guertin, Cosmo Lorelli, Nicholas Milan, and Robert Tosca. For Pennsylvania, Senior Paper, Isabel Schroeder. For Junior Individual Performance, Zachary Yaninek. From Oregon, for Senior Group Documentary, Caden Marks and Bethany Knutson. For her junior paper, Shamama Khan. From Oklahoma, Senior Group Exhibit, Zane Hilbig, Clint Stout, and Tanner Neely. For Junior Group Exhibit, Braxton Thompson, Kenzie Nix, Kylie Nix. From Ohio, for Senior Group Documentary, Hannah Flam and Emily Montenegro. For Junior Paper, Emma Rennie. For North Dakota, Senior Paper, Erica Red Tomahawk. For Junior Individual Documentary, Virginia Kahn. From North Carolina, Jordan Williams for a Senior Individual Documentary. Skylar Holland for Junior Individual Performance. From New York, Brianna Kovit for Senior Paper. For Junior Individual Documentary, Anish Mupidi. From New Mexico, for a Senior Group Documentary, Solomon Chavez, DeHaven Hudson, Matthew Smith, Courtney Wiggins. For Junior Group Performance, Alan Hilton, Brian Hilton. From New Jersey, for Senior Group Performance, Anjali Patel, Avni Patel, Shanna Martin, Evan Dang, Rebecca Luo. For Junior Group Documentary, Annika Agarwal, James Tang, Annie Joe, and Sophie Jang. For New Hampshire, Sophia Kim, Senior Individual Website. For Junior Group Exhibit, Abigail Mangiafico and Caitlin Hirnack. From Nevada, Christine Lay, Senior Individual Website. For Junior Group Website, Lena Kammermeyer and Liesl Kammermeyer. For Nebraska, for our Senior Individual Documentary, Dallas Jones. For their Junior Group Website, Lindsay Johnston, Nellie Rush, and Noah Talmadge. From Montana, Brittany Bowes for Senior Individual Exhibit, Emma Decker for Junior Individual Exhibit. From Missouri, Jay Mehta for Senior Individual Performance. For Junior Group Exhibit, Kylie Sobel and Emily Glazer. For their Senior Group Website, Cece Jang and James Travis. From Mississippi, for her junior individual exhibit, Davis McGee. From Minnesota, Kate Mahonen, for Senior Individual Exhibit. For Junior Individual Documentary, Theo Sage Martinson. From Michigan, Charles Parsons, for Senior Individual Website. For Junior Group Website, Ellie DeRussell and Victoria Woolley. From Massachusetts, Senior Group Documentary, Maggie Perota and Jacqueline Phoebe. For Junior Individual Documentary, Jessica Roa. From Maryland, Senior Individual Documentary, Matthew Bloom. For junior group website, Chris Ponduck, Jamie Rohn, Sydney Robinson, Nicholas Struntz, and Hannah Wang. From Maine, for senior group documentary, Cody Roy, Devin Poison, Dylan Goff, Abby Allen, Maddie Amaro. For junior individual website, Jamie Richardson. From Louisiana, Mary North Jones, for senior paper, Lauren Perkins, for junior individual performance. From Korea, Minsoo Samantha Kim, Sung Yun Sally Hong, Seung Yun Amy Kim, Jisoo Yoon, Jenny Jaewon Chung, for senior group performance. For junior group exhibit, Via Liu Bin Kim and Isabella Bake. From Kentucky, Meg Hancock, for senior individual documentary. For junior group website, Claire Kean and Rocco Rentmore. From Kansas, for senior group website, Catherine McLaughlin, Melissa Bryan. For junior individual exhibit, Audrey Nguyen Hong. From Iowa, for senior individual website, Cody Baker. Kyle Welch and Allie Welch, for junior group documentary. From Indiana, Diane Santos, for senior individual exhibit, and Ian Rentschler, for junior individual documentary. From Illinois, for senior group documentary, Caroline Caruso and Anna Kaganovich. For junior group documentary, Parita Shaw and Rosemary Mascarenas. From Idaho, Jillian Lamas, for senior individual performance. For junior group performance, Theo Troster Solbrig, Cameron Young, Heath Springman, and Tiger Liu. From Hawaii, for senior group performance, Jay Fung and Rachel Shumway. For junior individual website, Isabella Hartline. From Guatemala, for senior group documentary, Arturo Batista and Jose Pablo Saliezar. For junior group website, Bernardo Berga and Tomas Wilson. From Guam, Tazi Petra Pin Suan Chen, for senior group exhibit, and Logan Dana, for junior individual exhibit. From Georgia, Brooklyn Reese, for senior individual exhibit. For junior group website, Emma Goff and Zachary Goff. From Florida, Parker Beverly, for senior individual documentary, and Ilana Tricer, for junior individual performance. From the District of Columbia, for senior group performance, Terrain Ellsbrook and Maya Smith. For junior individual website, Chloe Fatsis. From Denver, Natalie No and Abigail Hausiel. For senior group exhibit, Eleni Stikos, for junior individual exhibit. From Connecticut, for senior group performance, Nicole Wood, Juliana Salomon, Catherine Hurst, Flora Devenich, and Devenich Braze. From Connecticut, junior group exhibit, Hunter Dale, Noah Vossington. From Colorado, for senior group performance, Cameron Dadone, Bryn Gauthier, Audrey Roberts, and Mia Nelson. For junior paper, Kaylin Waite. From China, for a senior group exhibit, Yoshiko Shi, Sophia Kong, Helen Jang, and Catherine Zhao. From California, senior group documentary, Elijah Gross-Sable, Ben Clark, and Adam Linson. For junior individual website, Drake Bolt. From Arkansas, for senior individual performance, Hadia Cummings. For junior group performance, Anna Gregg, Ethan Marot, and Olivia Marot. From Arizona, Sharon Vaz, for senior paper. For junior individual website, Ayla Young. From American Samoa, for senior individual website, Charu Josrose. For junior individual website, Ethan Langkield. From Alaska, Anna Marie Timling, for senior individual documentary. For junior website, Kate Masterman and Nina Harbison. And from Alabama, Hannah Taunton, for senior individual performance, and Elizabeth Ronimus, for junior individual documentary. Congratulations. right. Let's do junior individual website. To help me present the medals, I'd like to ask NHD trustee Julian Hipkins to come forward. Where is he?
There he is.
In third place for junior individual website, from Norman, Oklahoma, Nirvana Khan. Nirvana attends Irving Middle School. Teacher is Margaret Wadley. And the title of the bronze medal website, Petticoat Pilgrims, World War II Brides Explore Culture and Exchange Hope. Taking home a silver medal for junior individual website, Megan Lim from Occoquan, Maryland. Megan attends Occoquan Academy. Teacher is Arun Parakan. And the title of Megan's website, Alfred Russel Wallace, 8 Extraordinary Years in the Malay Archipelago. Is there somebody? Oh, there she is. From Maryland. Where is Maryland? Okay.
It's from Maryland, right?
Mm-hmm. All right, I'm going to announce the first place NEH Scholar Award for Junior Individual Website. And that goes to Lily Gardner from Lexington, Kentucky. Lily attends Winburn Middle School. Teachers are Michelle Kaysen and Megan Lilly. And the title of the website, An Unrepentant Risk Taker, Paul Durand Rule, Encountering Parisian Culture. Come on, first place. And now for senior individual website. In third place, taking home a bronze medal from St. John's, Florida, Danielle Haddock. Danielle attends Creekside High School. Her teacher is Laura Wynn. And the title of her website, Can You Tell Me How We Got to Sesame Street? Exploring a New Realm of Education. Taking home a silver medal from Houston, Texas, Denise Cordova. Denise attends MacArthur High School. Teacher is Julie Toma. And the title of her website, Ada Lovelace, the Enchantress of Computing, Exploring the Beginnings of the Information Evolution. And in first place, NEH Scholar from Hartford, Connecticut, Shay Pezzullo. Shay attends Classical Magnet School. I know, but she's got to wait. Shay attends Classical Magnet School. Teacher is Jeffrey Hoberman. And the title of the gold medal website, Dual and Duality, New Journalism, New York. Had to go home. All right. How about a few more special prizes? All right. We love special prizes. An outstanding entry on Asian American history. Sponsored by the National Park Service, Carol McBryant will help me hand out the medals. In the junior division, for an outstanding entry on Asian American history, from Lander, Wyoming, for her junior individual performance, Italia Fatch. She's from Lander Middle School. Her teacher is Gayla Hammer, and the title of her junior individual performance, The Fall of Saigon, Beauty for Ashes. And in the senior division, for an outstanding entry on Asian American history, from Boulder, Colorado, for their senior group exhibit, Solomon Bloomfield, Philip Ding, Jaden Hochstecker, and Ariana Constantopoulos. They attend Fairview High School. Their teachers are Lee Campbell Hale and Scott Peoples, and the title of their senior group exhibit, An Exclusive Encounter: The Denver Anti-Chinese Riot and the Chinese Exclusion Act. Next award is for an outstanding entry on naval history. This is the Captain Ken Koski Naval History Prize, sponsored by the Naval Historical Foundation. And I'd like to invite Mrs. Rosemary Koski and Matt Eng to help present the award. For the junior division, for an outstanding entry on naval history, from Mobile, Alabama, Cassandra Taylor, for her junior individual website. She attends Phillips Preparatory School. Her teacher is Cheryl Birch, and the title of her junior individual website, Exploring the CSS Alabama, Encounters of the Confederate Raider and the Fiery Exchange with the Kearsarge. And for the senior division, for an outstanding entry on naval history, from Johnston, Iowa, Allie Tubbs. Allie attends Johnston Middle School. Her teacher is Kathy Paul, and her senior individual performance is entitled Grace Hopper Dared to Explore Computer Coding, Encounter the Glass Ceiling, and Exchange Intellectual Concepts. And now for outstanding entry on Native American history, sponsored by the National Park Service, I'd like to ask Carol McBrien to join me again. In the junior division, for an outstanding entry on Native American history, from Shadron, Nebraska, Tyler Kaus. Tyler attends Shadron Middle School. Teacher is Kathy Kaus. And the title of Tyler's junior individual documentary, Thomas Savage, An Exchange at Jamestown. And in the senior division, for an outstanding entry on Native American history, from Lawrence, Kansas, Hillary Griggs. Hillary attends Bishop Seabury Academy. Hillary's teacher is Sonia Zarnecki, and the title of her senior paper, The Choteau Brothers, Exploration, Encounter, and Exchange in the 18th Century Missouri River Valley. Summer camp wins out. And now for outstanding entries on White House history, sponsored by the White House Historical Association, I ask that Courtney Speckman and Curtis Sandberg join me in presenting the medals. In the junior division, for outstanding entry on the history of the White House, for their junior group performance from Revere, Massachusetts, Astrid Umanzar, Brenda Batero, Eve Laskowitz, Marisol Palencia, and Kathy Umanzar. They attend Susan B. Anthony Middle School. Their teacher is Tina Petty, and the title of their junior group performance, Exploring the Role of First Ladies Through United States History. And in the senior division, for outstanding entry on the history of the White House, for their senior group exhibit from Shaker Heights, Ohio, Maddie Suna, Eunice Min, and Katie Campanelli. They attend Shaker Heights High School. Their teacher is Sarah Davis. And the title of their senior group exhibit, Eleanor Roosevelt's My Day. And now for junior group exhibit. I'd like to ask another one of our stalwart volunteers, Casey Smith, to help give out the medals for junior group exhibit. In third place for junior group exhibit from Woodbury, Minnesota, Roger Altman and Ryder Sitkowich. They attend Woodbury Middle School. Teacher is Alyssa Bagley, and the title of their exhibit, I Will Kill It. Jackson encounters the Second Bank of the United States, the Bank War. And in second place, taking home a silver medal from Cleveland, Ohio, Spendana Amarneni and Abida Hassan. They attend Birchwood School. Their teacher is Connie Miller. And the title of their junior group exhibit, An Old Enemy Becomes New, World War I's Deadliest Killer. Got a ways to go, so I will announce the first place NEH scholars for junior group exhibit from Singapore. Callie Elms, Mehek Jane, Tara Ampolini, and Trinity Yao. They attend Singapore American School. Their teacher is Matt Elms. And the title of their exhibit, The Apollo Soyuz Mission, Launching a Unified Exchange. All right, senior group exhibit. I would like to ask Kim Fortney to hand out the medals for our senior group exhibit. They're right in your hand. All right, in third place for senior group exhibit, from Irvine, California, Inji Sun, Bella Ann, and Kenny Chung. They attend Woodbridge High School. Teacher is Spencer Schwertfeger, and the title of their senior group exhibit, Perry Expedition, Exchange Through Encounter of Japan. And in second place, taking home silver medals from Baytown, Texas, Priscilla Garcia and Danielle Garcia. They attend Ross S. Sterling High School. Their teacher is Stephanie Cottle. And the title of their senior group exhibit, World War II Women Air Force Service Pilots, Exchanging Traditional Roles, Exploring Military Aviation, and Encountering Discrimination. And And first place, the NEH Scholar Award for Senior Group Exhibit. From Palm Harbor, Florida, Gabrielle Hines and Jennifer Gilby. They attend Palm Harbor University High School. Their teachers are Jason Sardulius and Sean Falcon. And the title of their first place winning exhibit, 15 Cents to See the Infants on Display. And now for a few more special prizes. Well, if you don't want them, we'll just end now. All right. Four. Outstanding entries using Chronicling America, Historic American Newspapers, sponsored by the National Endowment for the Humanities. I would like to ask Deputy Chairman Plimpton to give out these awards. For the Junior Division, from Highland, Indiana, Olivia DeJung. Olivia attends Highland Christian School. Teacher is Richard Vandervoet. And the title of her junior individual website, Nikola Tesla, Exploring Electricity. And in the senior division, for her senior individual performance, Claire Galvin from West Virginia. Claire's homeschooled, teacher is Laura Galvin, and the title of her performance, The Exploration, Encounter, and Exchange of Alicia Kent Kane. And now for an outstanding entry on the history of agriculture and rural life, I asked Douglas Helms of the Agricultural History Society to present the medal. For her junior individual exhibit, from the British School in Manila, Philippines, Gabrielle Uy. Gabrielle Uy attends the British School. Teachers Kate Petty and James Cox. And the title of Gabrielle's junior individual exhibit, The Columbian Exchange, The Beginning or the End?
There? Yes.
for an outstanding entry in the history of the federal government, sponsored by the Society for History in the Federal Government. I'd like to ask Suzanne Junod to help present the award. And now for an outstanding entry on the history of the federal government, for their junior group performance from Middlebury, Connecticut, Juliana Rodriguez, Max Bueno, Samantha Gilbert, Emily Strickland, and Joe Zarif. They attend Memorial Middle School. Their teachers are Sharon Ladarsik and Carl Buckley. And the title of their performance, Alexander Hamilton Explores a Financial System for the New Nation. All right, how about junior group performance? Mrs. Behring, would you like to give out the medals? In third place for junior group performance, from Arlington, Massachusetts, Ravati Vignac, Chiara Roberto, and John Steink. They attend Audison Middle School. Their teacher is Jason Levy. And the title of their performance, Radio Caroline and the Pirate DJs, Offshore Broadcasting to Explore Government Dominance Over British Radio. In second place for junior group performance from St. Paul, Minnesota, Cassette Isaacson, Preston Allman, Samuel Otten, Amari Peepcorn, and Tessa Rolfe. They attend Christ Household of Faith School. Their teachers are Dennis Simonson and Pam Alsbury. And the title of their performance, No More Hiroshima, an international exchange for peace. And in first place, for junior group performance, the NEH scholars are from Akron, Iowa, Jack Anderson, Jader Briggs, Megan Swancutt, Daytona Foley, and Logan Smith. They attend Akron Westfield Community School. Their teacher is Val Phillips. And the title of their performance, Route 66, The Road of Possibilities. And now for senior group performance. I would like to ask David Behring to present these awards. In third place for senior group performance, from St. Paul, Minnesota, Ari Geertz, Michaela Greenwood, Belinda Harms, Austin Otten, and Alyssa Schuett. They attend Christ Household of Faith School. Their teachers are Jenna Simonson and Pam Alsbury. And the title of their performance, We Were There Too, The Exchanging Roles of Women in World War II. Way up there. In second place, taking home a silver medal from Clovis, California, Allison Hodge, Sydney Fox, Kelsey Ewing, Matthew Clark, and Austin Cozy. They attend Buchanan High School. Their teacher is Debbie Hodge. And the title of their performance, American Exodus, The Okies Exploration, Encounter, and Exchange in the San Joaquin Valley. And in first place, the NEH Scholar Award goes to students from Woodstock, Georgia, Mercy Kohler and Devin Snyder. They attend Snyder Homeschool. Their teacher is Jennifer Snyder. And the title of their performance, Mary Musgrove, Exploration, Encounter, and Exchange in the Life of an Indian Princess. Called enthusiasm. And now for some special awards. Pronounced entry on Latino American history, sponsored by the National Park Service. I'd like to ask Carol McBryant to help present the medals. For the junior division, outstanding entry on Latino American history. For her junior paper from Traverse City, Michigan, Daniela Castillo. Daniela attends Traverse City West Middle School. Her teacher is Brett Graham. And the title of her paper, Rosario Castellanos, A Journey to Equality Through Self-Expression, an essay on exploration, encounter, and exchange. Thank you. And in the senior division, for an outstanding entry on Latino American history, for their senior group website from Moriarty, New Mexico, Yuki Armenta and Fabiola Melendez. They attend Moriarty High School. Their teacher is Amy Page, and the title of their website, Bracero Exchange, Encountering Labor Shortages and Exploring International Diplomacy. And now for special award and an outstanding entry on the history of the Civil War. And I'd like to ask our director of programs, Lynn O'Hara, to present this medal. For an outstanding entry on Civil War history, for their senior group exhibit from Chicago, Illinois, Madeline Moy and Audrey Pettigrew. They attend Peyton College Prep High School. Their teacher is Aaron Weiss. And the title of their group exhibit, 80 Acres of Hell, Camp Douglas and Its Impact on Warfare. And now for an outstanding entry on the history of baseball, sponsored by the Society for American Baseball Research. I'd like to ask Bruce Brown to present the Lee Allen History of Baseball Award. For the outstanding on the history of baseball, for his junior paper from Lovettsville, Virginia, Thomas McKenna. Thomas attends McKenna Homeschool. His teacher is Elizabeth McKenna. And the title of his junior paper, The Path to the Sugar Mill or The Path to the Millions, the MLB Baseball Academy's Effect on the Dominican Republic. Feel big. And now for outstanding entries on the history of civil rights, sponsored by the March on Washington Film Festival. I'd like to ask Celie Niehaus to help present the medals. For an outstanding entry on civil rights history in the junior division from Cleveland, Ohio, Jane Nielsen, for her junior paper. Jane attends Birchwood School. Her teacher is Connie Miller, and the title of her paper, Cleveland's Huff Riots, the violent encounter that ushered in new hope for African American leadership and municipal reform. And in the senior division, for an outstanding entry on the history of civil rights, from Morrison, Oklahoma, for their senior group website, Ray Lynn Parkham, Logan Wood, and Will Lauman. They attend Morrison High School. Their teacher is Patty Sanders, and the title of their group website, Brush Strokes and Bloodshed, Emory Douglas and the Rise of the Black Panthers. And now for a junior group documentary. And I would like to ask Rob Michelucci to help me present the medals. For third place, taking home bronze medals from Topeka, Kansas, Molly McLaughlin and Olivia Romig. They attend Seaman Middle School. Their teacher is Kyle Johnson. And the title of their documentary, The Americans Are Very Strong. Darn right. In second place for junior group documentary from Madison, Wisconsin, Sienna Perna and Lauren Stoneman. They attend Eagle School. Their teacher is Chuck Price. And the title of their documentary, The Munich Agreement, Exploring Peace, Encountering False Promises, and Exchanging Czechoslovakia for Peace in Our Time. And in first place, the NEH Scholar Award goes to Eleanor McCoy and Genevieve Haskins from Columbus, Georgia. They attend Richards Middle School. Their teacher is Stan Shively. And the title of their documentary, When Ballet Came to America. For senior group documentary. John. To help me give out the medals, John Gillum. In third place, for senior group documentary from Conway, Arkansas, Mary Nail and Kennedy Reynolds. They attend Conway High School. Their teacher is William Richardson. And the title of their documentary, Exposing the Big Picture, Lewis Hines' Exploration of the Social Documentary Genre as a Tool to Eliminate Child Labor. In second place for senior group documentary, from Daegu International School in Korea, James Pirug, Sunny Chung Lee, Miriam Sun, and Jenny Lee. Their teacher is Sharon Gillette. The title of their documentary, Reconstructing Korea's Crippled Economy, Korean Miners and Nurses in Germany. From Chapel Hill, North Carolina, Sydney Dye and Caroline Murphy. They attend Chapel Hill High School. Their teacher is Holly Loringer. And the title of their documentary, Introducing Americans to America. And now for a few more special prizes for an outstanding entry on United States Marine Corps history sponsored by the Marine Corps Heritage Foundation. I'd like to ask Claire Ball, their teacher in residence, to give out the medal. So for an outstanding entry on Marine Corps history, from Monument, Colorado, Ethan Roque. Ethan attends Palmer Ridge High School. Ethan's teacher is Mark Ewig, and the title of his senior individual website, The Barbary War, America's Birth as a Global Power. And the next prize is an outstanding entry on the Corps of Discovery, sponsored by the Lewis and Clark Trail Heritage Foundation. Michael Petty will help me present the medal. In the junior division, from Keene, New Hampshire, Caleb O'Mara and Jonas O'Mara. They attend Keene School. Their teacher is Sean O'Mara, and the title of their junior group website, To Extend the Bounds of Science and Promote the Acquisition of Knowledge. And in the senior division, from Charleston, South Carolina, Kevin Boyd and Adriana Carter. They attend Academic Magnet High School. Their teacher is Meredith Petty. And the title of their senior group website, Lewis and Clark, The Exploration of the Louisiana Territory. And to help me present the award for an outstanding entry in immigration history, sponsored by the Lombardo family, I'd like to ask our finance manager, Lorena Torres, to join me. For an outstanding entry on immigration history, for their senior group website from Montville, New Jersey, Zara Ammer, Nithya Reddy, Athena Nomula, and Anjali Shaw. They attend Montville Township High School. The teachers are Peter Porter and Stephanie Sanfilippo. And the title of their senior group website, Antonio Mucci and the Teletrofono. Where? Yeah? No?
No, they're right there.
Where? Oh, there.
You need professional spotters.
Next, awards for outstanding entry related to George Washington's leadership, sponsored by George Washington's Mount Vernon Estate Museums and Gardens, and Allison Wickens will help present the award. In the junior division, from Madison, Wisconsin, Libby Pleva. Libby attends Eagle School. Libby's teacher is Janice Lackock. And the title of her junior individual performance, Outwitting Them All, How George Washington's Culper Spy Ring Helped Win the American Revolution. And in the senior division, from Baytown, Texas, Matthew Broussard and Kylie Fanning. They attend Impact Early College High School. Their teachers are Steve Koester and Michael Fanning. And the title of their senior group documentary, From Confederation to Nation. How about junior group website? Woo. I'd like to ask Amy Boning to help present the awards for junior group website. Wake up. In third place for junior group website, from Peoria, Arizona, Aman Argawal and Daksh Gopalani. They attend Basis Peoria School. Their teacher is Andrew Estes. And the title of their website, Unit 731, Perpetrators of the Asian Holocaust. And in second place for junior group website, from Austin, Texas, John Leeds and Evan Weldon. They attend Austin area homeschoolers. Their teacher is Jennifer Leeds, and the title of their website, The March on Polio.
They're on vacation? I don't know. They're in India.
They're in India. It's not a bad excuse. And in first place, the NEH scholars are from San Clemente, California, Sophia Burrick, Kelly McDonald, Catherine McKernan. They attend Shorecliffs Middle School. Their teacher is Brian Campbell, and the title of their website, Feminists in Flight, Exploring Gender Equality at 32,000 Feet. How about senior group website? Yeah. I would like to ask Erica Washington to help present these awards. In third place for senior group website, from New City, New York, Vivek Matthew, William Bassin, Charlie Weiland, Ailed Raymond and Joseph Vailumaka. They attend Clarkstown North Senior High School. Their teachers are Jordan Turner and Kenneth Amparo. And the title of their website, The Erie Canal, an innovation in American economics and culture. There they are. In second place for senior group website, from Fairbanks, Alaska, Brian Eli and Tegan Donaldson. They attend West Valley High School. Their teacher is Heather DiMario. And the title of their website, China's Surge into Silk, the Exploration, Encounter, and Exchange of the Silk Road. And taking home a gold medal in the NEH Scholars Award from St. Paul, Minnesota, Grace Gardner and Sylvan Gardner. They attend Open World Learning Community. Their teacher is Katie Craven. And the title of their group website, The Visionary Exploration of Jacques Cousteau, Changing Perceptions of the Ocean Through Undersea Encounters. Who wants two round-trip tickets on Southwest Airlines? randomly selected. We have no idea who this is, but if you are sitting in section 113, row 8, and seat 14, you just won 2 round-trip tickets. Evelyn just won. All right, it's time for the scholarships. So I would like to ask Dr. Jim Harris to present these awards. There's Chaminade University first, and then Maryland, and then I'll hand it to Ted.
Okay, so you can do the Chaminade. So for Chaminade University of Honolulu, the recipient of this scholarship is Vanessa Taylor. She comes from Ainsworth Community Schools. Her category was Senior Individual Documentary. The title of her documentary was The Day of Two Noons, Railroad Encounters with Time. And the teachers were Nicole Flynn and Heather Luder.
Right here.
Nebraska.
Nebraska. Sorry. These people were from Nebraska, folks. Sorry about that.
Kim, medals.
Is that her coming down? And for the University of Maryland scholarship,
go Terps.
Right, go Terps, right. From the George Washington High School in Denver, Colorado, John Woodliffe Stanley is the recipient. His category was the Senior Individual Website. The title of his production was The End of Apartheid in South Africa, Political Encounters and Economic Exchange that Led to the End of a Segregated Nation, and the teacher was Richard Leeds.
And now to present the award for the Case Western Reserve University Scholarship, the David Van Tassel Founder Award, is NHD Trustee Ted Prossy.
Greetings from Cleveland, Ohio. The birthplace and emotional home of National History Day. Case Western Reserve each year allows us to award a full tuition scholarship renewable for 4 years. We hope and trust that you will then participate fully in the National History Day program in Cleveland, because we need your help and we want your help. David Van Tassel, after whom the award is named, is the founder of National History Day, and each year at this time we remember him, because all of us hope for a legacy. David has created one that lives on year after year into the future. This award goes to someone in the category of senior individual documentary, to Jordan Williams from J.H. Rose High School in Greenville, North Carolina. Jordan's teacher is Stephanie Knowles, and the title is Exploring Plants and Society, the Life-Altering Encounters of Dr. Persian L. Julian. Right here?
Well, the
one for each?
Envelope goes to.
Goes to. Goes
and the mail.
And the mail? Okay. Well, we'll do this.
Kenneth E. Behring National History Day Contest of 2016. Next year's theme is Taking a Stand in History. I hope to see you all back here then. In the meantime, have a safe trip home.